And then I saw South Africa.
Alors j'ai vu.
I saw a dark cloud coming over South Africa.
J'ai vu la République sud-africaine. J'ai vu un
if there are people in South Africa watching
sur
me,
la République sud-africaine.
We need to pray for South Africa.
Les Sud-Africains qui me regardent,
as I was looking at that dark cloud,
alors que je regardais ces nuages noirs,
I saw the people down.
J'ai vu les gens mourir.
It's like there is no. Oh, Spirit of God, help me.
Oh, Esprit de Dieu, aide-moi.
Yes,
Jesus.
South Africa, we need to pray for South Africa.
Nous devons prier pour la République démocratique.
I had the angel shouting, pray for South Africa.
Pray for South Africa. Pour la République sud-africaine.
Pray for South Africa.
Prions pour la République sud-africaine.
This beautiful South Africa you see now.
Cette jolie République qu'on voit
aujourd'hui. The enemy wants to destroy it in 10 days.
L'ennemi veut le détruire en 10 jours.
All that beauty you see.
Oh God, have mercy.
He wants to cause a mass of people coming out and stealing, breaking, and destroying everything in
10
days. Because it's no light, I saw darkness.
Il n'y avait plus de lumière. J'ai vu les ténèbres, l'obscurité.
Pray for South Africa.
Prions pour la République.
And number two, I saw. Unbelief was risen to a higher level.
Un incroyant est élevé.
Unbelief against churches.
Quelqu'un croyant contre les
pasteurs.
Un croyant contre les pasteurs.
We need to pray for light.
Devons prier pour la lumière.
I had the angel shouting, pray for South Africa.
Pray for South Africa.
Pray for South Africa.
South Africa's army says that it will deploy soldiers to help quell unrest sparked by the jailing of former President Jacob Zuma. At least 6 people have been killed in the looting and protests. Violence broke out last week when Zuma began serving a 15-month sentence for contempt of court. Now, looters have ransacked a mall in the coastal city of Durban overnight. Another shopping mall lay in ruins in nearby regional capital of KwaZulu-Natal after it was torched on Sunday. This unrest is mainly concentrated in Zuma's home province of KwaZulu-Natal, but it is also spreading to Johannesburg, South Africa's economic powerhouse.
Well, we've had some members being shot at, and one member's been shot at in the Parlok area. That we got news of early this morning. We've had an incident of a shooting in the Tongat area this morning as well, and a community member has been shot by trying to protect his community. We really don't know which way this is going to go, but if it does continue this way, it's going to be an escalation to another level completely, because communities in general are now tired and they cannot tolerate this. I mean, we've been out all night from last night all the way till now. And all you really hear is like a war zone. It's actually literally like a war zone out here. Mm. There's just gunshots and firing all around.
This beautiful South Africa you see now,
the
enemy wants to destroy it in 10 days. All that beauty you see.
Oh God, have mercy.
He wants to cause a mass of people coming out and stealing, breaking, and destroying everything.
Sporadic violence continues in South Africa for the 4th consecutive day after the arrest of former President Jacob Zuma.
Stealing, breaking, and destroying everything. Stealing, breaking, and destroying everything. I saw a dark cloud coming over South Africa.
J'ai vu la République sud-africaine, j'ai vu.
Pietermaritzburg, the capital of the province, is on standstill. Durban, the economic hub of the province, is on standstill. Let me tell you what it means. It means more jobs will be lost. It means it will plunge the economy into chaos. This is the current situation. chaos, anarchy, criminality continues. It started off as a pro-Jacob Zuma campaign, his supporters calling for him to be released from jail. He's serving his 15 months in prison. But right now, I can tell you that it's no longer about the former president. What we are witnessing is pure criminality, is pure lawlessness, and it's up to law enforcement authorities to deal decisively with what is happening.